Hi, it's me, Gabe Alcala here from Advanced Test Equipment Rentals, and today we're going to be going over Fluke Network's Certifiber Pro Optical Loss Test Set. The configuration you see here is going to be the quad version, since it'll do both the single mode testing and the multimode testing all in one pair of modules. Each package is going to come with a Versiv main unit, a Versiv remote unit, and the Certifiber modules installed on the rear already. It's also going to include a reference set for the single mode LC, the multi-mode 50 micron, and the 62.5 micron. I want to mention that both of these are going to be encircled flux compliant reference cord sets. It's also going to come with optical cleaning pads, LC couplers for sending references and connecting cables under test, the LinkWare software CD, the Fluke product manual set, the Getting Started guide, a USB cable in case you want to update the firmware at a later date, two AC adapters to charge lithium-ion batteries, and a carry case to carry all these items in. The goal for today's demonstration is to fiber certify this 15-foot LC 50 micron multimode cable. To do that, I'm going to require both my Versiv mainframe, my remote unit, the Certifiber Pro modules installed in the rear, my LC 50 micron test reference cord set, two LC duplex couplers, and my fiber optic connector cleaning tool. The first step I'm going to do is actually create the test using my main Versiv controller. To do that, I'm going to be inside the project menu and then press new test, then change the fiber settings to 50 micron. I'm going to set my test limit, and now I'm going to use the generic fiber optic. Confirm that the connectors are correct. I'm going to be using LC for this demonstration. Then hit save. The next step is going to be cleaning all my fiber connections using my fiber optic connector cleaner. Each of the test reference sets are going to come with two of the encircled flux cables and then two of the standard reference patch cables. Keep in mind that only the multimode will use the encircled flux compliant technology. Single mode will just use standard patch cables. I have marked each one of the connectors with either black tape or red tape to allow easier identification during the setting of the reference. To set the reference, you're going to want to be at the home screen and then press the set reference button. And then the main unit and the remote unit are going to pop up on the screen because it's going to give you a graphical representation of what connectors you have to put where. And to start the whole process, you're going to want to press the run wizard button. And now the first step is going to be connecting the red connector off one of the encircled flux compliance cords. Now I'm going to connect another red one to the multimode out of the remote unit. After that's connected, I'm going to press next. And I'm going to attach the opposite end, which is a black connector, to the remote unit's input. So I'm going to do that now. And I'll do the same with the opposite end of the remote unit's output to the main unit's input. When you hear the beep, that means the main unit and the remote unit are now communicating. So I'm going to press set reference. And now we're going to want to press next again to verify the reference cord is correct. Now the next step is going to be removing the black connector from both inputs. So I'll set these on the side and press next and connect that second set of reference cords I showed you earlier. So I'm connect a black connector to the main unit's input. And a black connector to the remote's unit's input. Then I'm going to press next. Now using one of our LC duplex couplers, I'm going to connect all four LC connectors. The red connector on this side next to the black connector off the main unit, followed by the black connector coming off the remote unit just in front of the red connector from the main unit. Then connect the last red connector next to the black connector. Then I'm going to press the TRC verification button. Then press the next key. Now that my reference is set, I'm going to remove one set of the patch cords. After that's removed, I'm going to press the next button. Install a second set of LC couplers in the same configuration we set the reference. I'm going to install my LC duplex patch cord that I'm going to be testing on this coupler and on the other coupler on the far end. After you hear the beep, that means you have confirmed the connection, and I'm going to press the home button. And now to begin the actual test, I'm going to press the test button. And as you can see here, it passed the test, and I'm going to want to press the save button. Then followed by save again. If you'd like to see some of your saved results, you're going to want to press the home button. Then click on the results tab, and you can see all the tests that this tester has done that you've saved. To transfer your test results onto a USB thumb drive, you have to be at the main menu. You're going to install the USB thumb drive onto the USB port on the side of the Versiv controller. Now press results. Press transfer. And now we're going to export these to this USB flash drive. And now I'm going to select our ATEC project and press export. And this tells us that it is finished exporting those files. Now I'm going to press OK and remove the USB thumb drive. The first thing I'm going to do is insert my LinkWare CD into my CD drive. Then the folder will come up, so I'll click on Open Folder. Then I'll click on LinkWare version 8.2. I'm going to press Yes. And this will begin the installation wizard. And press Next here. Agree to the terms and conditions. Press next. Press next. And within a few minutes, the LinkWare will be installed. This message will tell you that the installation is complete, and I'm going to press finish. Now I'm going to insert my USB thumb drive, double click on the LinkWare icon, and click on File, Import From, Test Files, and from here I'm going to find my USB thumb drive. And I'm going to select the project that I called ATEC and the file itself, and then press OK. I'm I'm going to press import all test results to import all 5 tests. And from here you can see all the tests that got uploaded. On this test that passed, I'm going to click on detail to actually see the results. And if I want to export to PDF, I'm going to click on the PDF tab, then select selected records in list, and I'm going to save that to my desktop. And I'm going to call our project ATEC. Then press save. If I want to export my test results onto a PDF document, I'm going to click on the PDF icon, then select on select records in list, and I'm going to save this as project 1. Then press save. So you can see here the PDF saved to my desktop, and I can scroll down and see my test results. And this concludes our how-to video.